Yeah, it's first time. shared their stories for contributing in this way, as well as my appreciation for the work they do every day. I believe this report complements the work being done and led by my colleague George Davis in the domestic abuse strategy, and I would like to ask all members to read and to share this report. It's a way in which we can all support Wirral being a place where domestic abuse is not tolerated. And I'm really pleased to see that many members are still wearing their badges, still keeping this campaign in the forefront. It's been an absolute privilege to by being a domestic abuse press champion, and I've handed that baton over to my fantastic colleagues and to ensure she will keep it for the win. Thank you everyone for your support.
Petitions on the agenda. In accordance with Standing Order 21. Petitions. Yeah, Councillor Jones.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Can I please present a petition on behalf of a substantial number of signatories regarding the planning application of the old check site of New Brighton, and I request that the petition be passed on to the appropriate officers.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you very much. I've got a petition from the less than 2,150 people asking the council to ensure that the car wash in Mells at Car Lane is allowed to continue to operate. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Now we move on to consideration of the petition. Received more than 3,000 signatures, and according to the council petition scheme, the lead petitioner has been invited to speak to this petition for up to 5 minutes, following which the council will have up to 15 minutes to debate the petition.
and you ask us to entrust our loved ones to a third party. Your process, so far as carers are concerned, has been flawed from the start. Decide an end product, closure, and then work backwards to find a solution to fix it. We find no evidence whatsoever of user support for change. We have objectively polled Girtrell Court users using an open question polling document, and their data conflicts with the closure. I challenge this council to make full disclosure of their case for choice to the Scrutiny Committee for Independent Validation. Mr. Phil Davis has repeatedly used the phrase equal or better. That begs the question, who decides what is equal or better? Surely it should be the users of the service. Well, Mr. Davis, you are a long way from equal to or better at the moment. You have a potential building and a potential service provider. You do not have a service specification, a term for the contract, which is absolutely vital for carers. We want to know that this is not a flash in the pan. There is no comparable staffing ratio data. There is no confirmation that users will have an equal to time allocation. There is no information on the range or extent of user activities necessary to equal Girtrell, or is this new service going to be just a babysitting service? In short, you do not have and are far from a complete package which will enable anyone to evaluate equal or better. Recent correspondence and press releases, including emails from your chief executive, claim that the closure decision has been made in partnership with carers. This is categorically untrue. None of the carers have agreed to the closure of Girtrell Court. Carers, including myself, have offered our views on the comparative virtues of three properties and provider combinations, but with the sole motivation of ensuring that any alternative solution was the best out of the limited choice available. This was not and is not an agreement to, or approval for Girtrell closure. The property chosen has some virtues, but, and it is a big but, accommodation is on three floors, and even with a lift, there are concerns over evacuation capability in the event of fire. I am told that one of the principal reasons for closing Maple Home was an identical concern over evacuation capability. Please do not use this as a Tory versus Labour standing match, which has characterised every debate on Girtrell. Both propositions have occurred under the remit of DAS, so why is what was unacceptable then suddenly acceptable now? I come to timescales. You were told at the start that the end of March was unachievable. My petition cited the end of September as a possible progress date. Now work on the property is unlikely to be completed by the end of November at best, and only then can a Care Quality Commission approval be sought. So even with a fair wind, the end of December seems optimistic. This ill-managed project has caused worry, distress and concern not only to service users but to their carers, many of whom are much older than I, have greater burdens to carry and who do not need Wirral Borough Council, subjecting them to 9 months or more of added stress. We come back to the starting point. You should have and could have used this financial year to plan and design a replacement service while allowing users the confidence that Girtrell will continue seamlessly until an equal to or better service offering has been constructed. Instead, you have reverse engineered a flawed solution which does this council and its officers no credit whatsoever. The petition has attracted over 7,000 signatures, but you should ignore this level of public support and moreover do so by muzzling your own councillors using a three-line whip to stifle those amongst you with compassion and conscience is a travesty of democracy for which this administration should be truly ashamed. The bare minimum that hard-pressed carers should be afforded is consultation on the full package solution as identified earlier. If I may read a portion of the petition because it is pertinent. Our demand is simple. Retain the excellent Girtrell Court and its professional caring staff until the council has researched carer and care for needs, analysed research costed and fully consulted on the suitability of any replacement offering. Solution before dissolution. Thank you for your time.
On three levels. Disgrace.
Can I just say, people are trying to speak in. It's a democratic debate.
We've been trying to speak.
Well, let her speak,
sense. Outside, otherwise I'm going to remove you.
She's talking nonsense.
People around you as well want to listen to the debate, who agree with you, and you're stopping them from listening. So please have some manners.
Because the building had become apparently not fit for purpose.
social services or myself have taken the delegated decision that virtual court will close at the end of November, and this will give choice to all people with learning disabilities who need respite. Thank you, Mr. Dudley.
Shocking, shocking.
Yeah, so therefore, who would you believe, the director or the cabinet? Mr. Mayor, yes, of course, it's imperfect, but the director has £1 million to spend on gears, of course. He can bring it up to a better facility, should he choose to. But you could either just, you know, throw these people out to the public-private sector without much care, without much care for their feelings, for their loved ones, and say £155,000. Mr. Mayor, a couple of weeks ago, the Cabinet found £3 million for care room fees, with £1.5 million in reserves, but they can't find £155,000 to get to the court. Mr. Mayor, Council are going to spend £30,000 on fireworks, but they can't find
£155,000
to get to the court. Shocking, shocking. Their priorities have raised, Mr. Mayor. They need to think again. It's not too late. You can keep care room. People want it as
a choice, give them their choice. Yeah. Councillor Adams. Thank you very much. Very, very brief indeed. But as I previously said to the council, in previous space, I've got three residents who are forward to Wells Morley who use this. And they're constantly talking to me about their great concerns here. I just want to say again how disappointed I am in the way you are dealing with together with Phil, who's keeping very quiet at Civic Mayor. Although we will say something later. Chris, it's not supposed to be party political, but it's becoming more and more as if you're running, just taking over the whole running of this council without consideration of everybody else.
No democracy. Not a democracy.
For you to now just tell us that you and the director together have made the decision to close in November, I just find this quite horrifying. And what's happened to our democracy? What's going on in the castle? I do wonder. Because
services truly tailored to the physical, recreational and emotional needs of the users and are demonstrably appropriate to their ages and circumstances. And I went on to write about the transition. Now it appears, Mr. Mayor, a lot of work, I can appreciate, has been done over the past 6 months or so to try and get to the situation where an alternative service is now being built. What I would suggest, Mr. Mayor, is that in the light of the Cabinet member's decision, we recognise that that work was eventually carried out. It was carried out in order to meet the expressed wishes of service users and their families, so we're told. But we accept that work has been carried out, but we have some questions still. We're anxious that the officers continue to endeavour to meet any outstanding service needs brought to their attention. And we also want to see a progress report on these outstanding concerns raised by the petitioners tonight, and that should be circulated to all members so that we're assured that the issues they've raised aren't overlooked.
The starting point for the administration is
name of...
And then when we did a survey, Mr. Mayor, in April, of the people using Girtrell Court, that was borne out by the outcome of the survey. So of 101 people using Girtrell Court, only 55 wanted a bed-based service. 28 wanted direct payments, 8 wanted shared lives, 5 wanted supported living, and 5 wanted to use Barnstonbury. So we know from talking to the users of the Girtrell Court that they didn't all want a bed-based option, and therefore we were responding to the outcome of that consultation by enabling us to use the money that we are currently spending
by closing it down
to provide those different options. And I am confident that by the end of November, I went to see the Tolly Mash Road property at lunchtime, and it is going to be, I think it's going to be fantastic.
What about evacuation procedures on 3 floors?
At the end of November.
I did ask you before, keep quiet please, by members on both sides of speaking. In democracy, you might not like what is said, but you agree to their right to say it. I'm sure you all agree on that. And as I said before, you're stopping other people on your own side from listening to the debate. So please have some manners. And I do notice, as last time, it's the same 2 people shouting and screaming all the
time. It's not a democracy.
So please, it is democracy.
It's not.
Otherwise, I'll ask you to leave. So please, please, listen to the debate.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. So I can absolutely guarantee, I can confirm, that there's no whip on this side of the chamber. We have debated this as a group long and hard. And we believe we are responding to the needs of our users, our service users. By enabling the money that we currently spend on respite care to be used a different way to meet a wider series of options than just a bed-based service. And at the end of the day, I believe that we are here to meet the needs of our residents, and I absolutely am confident that this is what we're doing by this decision, and I think this is the right one for all. Thanks, Mr. Mayor.
Yeah.
So,
Mr. Rennie.
Thank you,
Mr.
Mayor.
Mr.
Mayor, I truly wasn't going to speak here tonight, but I do actually feel sick to the stomach of this is actually being done in the name of this council. I'm sorry, Mr. Mayor, if I become emotional. I'm not really an emotional person, but the last couple of weeks I have spent time with a close friend looking for a provision for him to place his elderly father. I have to say, it's absolutely heartbreaking. We know that when you move people, whether they be young and old, that clearly is a detriment to their health. And I really feel for the carers, and particularly what Mr. Halley has been saying here tonight, because those people who attend Girtrell Court have been going there in the main for many years. Their health cannot be improved by going to a new establishment away from where they know, away from the people that they know, and probably away for many of the staff who they have come to know, trust, and in a lot of cases, love. Mr. Mayor, I think this is absolutely an appalling decision for this council to make. This new place, I'm sure, in Tolly Mash Road will be state-of-the-art. I've seen many state-of-the-art care homes, nursing homes, in the last couple of weeks, and it's delightful to see some of them, but they are like 5-star hotels. But is it really all about having an ensuite facility, which, let's face it, Mr. Mayor, a lot of people, their disabilities, that is just not practical, Mr. Mayor. So it's not about a fancy building, but at the moment we don't know what the standard of care will be, because the Care Quality Commission hasn't even had the opportunity
scrutiny committee did, and was then Families and Wellbeing, now People, did undertake a piece of in-depth scrutiny work after interviews and offers had been made. We talked about it last week in the planning meeting that we had for the work programme. We agreed that would be a good piece of work to do, looking at the whole exercise from a carer's perspective. So that's already on the work programme for People. Well, it will be when it's agreed on Thursday night, if it's agreed on Thursday night.
Another travesty.